In my previous lecture, I discussed the role of turmeric in patients with rheumatoid arthritis. Today, I will discuss the current evidence of using turmeric in patients with osteoarthritis or the wear and tear arthritis. Is turmeric helpful? Let's find out.
Rheumatologistoncall.com.
Hi, I'm Dr. Gurneeta, the founder of Rheumatologist on Call. In this YouTube channel, I educate patients about arthritis, autoimmune diseases, and the best ways that you can use to live better with arthritis. If you are new here, welcome. Don't forget to subscribe. But if you have been following this channel for a while, I'm excited to have you back and share more information with you. What is turmeric or curcumin? Turmeric is also called the golden spice and comes from the root of the plant called Curcuma longa. This is a plant that comes from the family of ginger. Its major ingredient is called curcumin. Curcumin gives turmeric that yellowish golden color. For many centuries, this spice has been used in the Asian cuisine, and it's very well recognized for anti-inflammatory, antioxidants, and anti-cancer properties. Over 10,000 studies have been reported in the literature regarding curcumin biological activities, including more than 120 clinical trials. Is turmeric or curcumin good for osteoarthritis? Let me tell you what osteoarthritis is. Osteoarthritis, or as commonly known, the wear and tear arthritis, is a form of arthritis seen primarily in elderly people. Many joints can be affected, including the thumbs, other fingers, shoulders, knees, hips, and many times the spine. The pain in the joints is worsened by moving or cold or rainy weather, and it's improved by rest or a heating pad. Now let's talk about the current scientific evidence of using turmeric or curcuma longa in patients with osteoarthritis. In 2018, a meta-analysis of nutritional supplements for patients suffering with osteoarthritis of the knees, hands, and hip was published. This included 69 studies, and they looked at more than 20 different supplements. In their analysis, they included studies about turmeric, glucosamine, chondroitin, collagen, and many other supplements. These supplements were compared to placebo. Now, remember that placebo treatments are included in trials to make sure a medication actually works. A placebo treatment has no real effect other than the mental effect, which we use to test whether results are due to the treatment or simply to the belief of the patient. Returning to the results of the study, interestingly, when compared to placebo, only 7 out of 20 supplements, including curcuma longa extract, showed to have an impact on reducing the joint pain and improving the function of the joints. Randomized controlled trial published in 2020 that looked at 70 patients with osteoarthritis of the knee with an ultrasound confirmed effusion, which means that they had fluid in their joints. They randomized patients to receive curcuma longa, 1,000 milligrams daily versus placebo. After 3 months, the patients who received curcuma longa had greater reduction in their pain level when compared to placebo, but the effusion or the fluid remained the same. Another very interesting study, published in 2016, is a meta-analysis which included 15 randomized controlled trials, a total of 1,600 patients with osteoarthritis, which they received curcuma longa or placebo. The patients that received curcumin actually showed again decrease in their pain level. So the other interesting fact was those patients who received curcuma longa compared to patients that received anti-inflammatory medication had very similar effects. The patients receiving curcumin extract had similar effect on joint pain, function, and very important, with less side effects compared to anti-inflammatory or non-steroidal anti-inflammatory medication. Remember that using non-steroidal anti-inflammatory medication for a prolonged period of time could increase your risk to develop heartburns, stomach ulceration, liver or kidney failure, and will increase your risk for heart attacks. How much turmeric should be used? Based on these studies that I just presented, the dose of turmeric or curcuma longa extract was between 1 and 2 grams per day. An important detail is that the products that you use need to contain black pepper because that will boost the absorption of curcumin. In summary, before you start any supplement, I do advise you to discuss your clinical situation with a physician that will be able to review your risk and benefits. Supplements can be dangerous in certain situations and can influence the way that other medications are absorbed. This is just an educational lecture that will not provide you with medical advice. If you like the educational content of these videos, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. So don't forget to click on the notification button to let you know when the next video will be released. Have a wonderful day.
Rheumatologistoncall.com